What's cracking, Jump Nation family? It's your boy here, Rushi S, aka the Jump Rope Coach. Welcome back to another quick fire jump rope tutorial piece where today I'm going to be teaching you the infamous Southpaw double under move. Now, if you guys are wondering what the hell this move is all about, I'm going to show you a clip in 3, 2, 1. Let's roll it. Memories bring back So there you have it, peeps, an absolute epic, slick move that you need to get into your transitions and combinations. Really good for your workouts as well. So wherever you are in the world, just wanna make sure that you guys are keeping safe, you're staying at home, and you guys have got this to power your workout. So remember, if you're new to Rush Athletics TV, I wanna say a massive warm welcome. This is the home of jump rope tutorials, workouts, and everything you need to know on how to skip like a boss. So do smash that subscribe button, hit up the website right now. We are still shipping worldwide, guys. You need to get yourself this bad boy. This is the most in-demand speed rope on the planet. This is the Rush Athletic Speed Rope, also known as the Money Rope. Go check us out online. Use YouTube 10 for 10% discount, and we are available on most major Amazons. So guys, we get straight into this tutorial. We're not gonna basically faff around too much. This is a kind of intermediate to advanced tutorial. So the term southpaw sort of side swing, southpaw double unders, this is a kind of term or kind of move that I coined. Named it the Southpaw after the film Southpaw with Jake Gyllenhaal. And this tutorial I kind of brought out about 2 years ago, right? So we're reloading this video. But I would go back and check that video because it was pretty much the fundamentals, the sort of foundations on how to basically build this move up. Since then, I have sort of mastered the move a lot better and I've got a lot more kind of cleaner tips and advice to kind of share with you today. So after watching the sort of boxing film and seeing Jake do it, I thought this move can look a lot cleaner. Obviously, Jake's an actor, and he probably just learned skipping for a couple of months whilst he was training for that kind of acting role, as it were. But this is the sort of southpaw side swing, guys. This is each side you're gonna be opening the rope, each side swing. This is the conventional side swing. 1, 2, open. 1, 2, open. The conventional boxer's side swing. The southpaw side swing opens on both sides. I've added my own kind of modifications to it. You can see my footwork. I kind of jump up on one leg. You can do it from sort of both legs if you're sort of beginner, just like this. And you can add some cool variations after. So the key kind of takeaways from this video, peeps, is to watch your wrist position, your hands, and your kind of forearms, as it were, okay? So if you're doing this sort of basic step, right, I want you to watch my hands. I'm gonna always make sure that, for example, if I go to my left-hand side, ready for the open, the right hand stays on top here, but I cock this kind of wrist backwards. What that's gonna help me basically do is it's gonna make sure that the rope doesn't tangle. And when I come to opening the rope, I get a really clean whip open so that I get the revolution speed that I need. Where most people go wrong is that they keep the wrist really close, they try and open the rope, you get really bad arcs, doesn't look clean, and you're basically gonna most likely trip. Like here, I'm not tripping, I'm trying my hardest to trip. There you go, there's a trip. A lot of people, when they go wrong with this move, is it's a little bit too slow. They're kind of just lots of arms involved. Like this, very armsy. To get the whip, you really want to focus in on those wrists, cocking back, flicking open. I like to call it a kind of wrist snap. Snap that wrist open, get a really nice revolution. Then you can kind of mix up the footwork as you want, right? You can go basic bounce, that's so. Right, now, getting tired. You've done that first part really nice and clean. You can do that basic sort of step. You can do it with boxer step, however you like. Now you wanna learn the double under part of it, right? So, double under part, right? The way to kind of focus in on double under part, how I like to do it anyway, is you start slow. So here is the double under. Now, when you are doing this double under, peeps, remember, it's not about speed. I've been talking about the wrist cocking back, open it nice and sharp. I haven't once mentioned you have to move quickly with this. Have to move quickly with your arms, have to move quickly with the wrist. Have to try and get that out of your mind. It's all about the timing, okay? When you are doing this and you make it look good, it's the timing that's gonna make it look literally epic, slick, comfortable looking, right? So what I mean by this, I want you to kind of focus on the timing now. So you're gonna start here, I want you to go to a basic bounce, what you're gonna do is you're gonna get really kind of handsy with this, okay? You're gonna just have the rope nice and light in your hands. Right now, I've got a couple of fingers off the handle of the skipping rope. I'm just showing you that you wanna be nice and light with the rope. You wanna feel nice and comfortable, no tension on the rope. You're not gripping it too hard. From here, what I want you to do is you want to increase the size or the height of your jump. Teaching you this move is more difficult because it's all down to how you prefer your timing to be, how you prefer your height of your jumps, the sort of style of your hands, what they're gonna be like. You just have to literally learn when you cock that hand back, you need to be able to swing the rope, get it from that cock position, snap it back. You need to get the rope to come down literally just before you land. That's where the timing is most perfect. I'll show you again. So you're here, remember, increase the size of your jumps. Now, you're gonna try this and you're probably gonna think, this looks easier than it is. Like obviously, it's gonna be tough, right peeps? I just want you to keep in mind, this is not about going fast. You can go fast, of course you can go fast. But you need to try and practice it going as slow as possible. I've talked about this in so many of my tutorials, but I'm always gonna repeat it because it literally is the golden key, the golden kind of advice, technique. If you can go slow with all the moves that I show you, whether it be crossovers, double unders, really nice and slow, then you can start to piece together. And this is about 50% speed. So you need to try and get the technique right with the hands. Remember, keep them separated. Keep the sort of top hand, cock it back, whip it open. Okay, so try this drill. Same spot. Start from a standing jump, left, right, keeping the wrist apart, cock that wrist back. Here we go. Big deep breath. Here we go. There we go, man. Really nice and easy. Keep it nice and gentle. Landing on your balls of your feet. It's typical. If you could do a double under, you can nail this move. You just need to get the techniques right. I guess what the next step you want to really learn, guys, is how can you build this into combinations? But my favorite is this combo. That about probably wraps up this tutorial. So I'm gonna leave it there. I'm out of breath, I'm dead. Remember, the southpaw double under is not easy, won't come overnight. Don't expect to try and learn this in 20 minutes or just after watching this video. Put in the time, effort, and the practice. So I hope that helps. Remember, do give this video a big, big, big thumbs up. I really appreciate it. Absolutely sweltering in today's heat. So guys, I'm gonna love you and leave you, and I'm gonna see you in that next video. So without further ado, take care of yourself, skip the treadmill, stay safe, peace.
Was the knight in shining armor in your movie? Well, put your lips on mine and love the aftertaste now.